Hi guys, it's Andrea, and today I'm going to be reading some of your doll stories, so like some interesting encounters that you guys have had, like taking photos in public, or your moments that you've had as a teen or adult collector. So I asked you guys to send in some of your stories on Instagram, and I'm gonna be reading some of them now. These are really interesting, and it's gonna be a lot of fun, so let's get started. The star doll sent in, I was buying a doll at an antique store, and the older lady owner started talking to me about Barbie and they were so excited that I still like dolls. I was 18 at the time and it was so cute. I love stories like these, like, yes, let's normalize. It is normal to have dolls past being a younger kid. Like, it's completely normal. It really should be normalized, and I love stories like this. Allison Dolan sent in, last summer, I took Joss on vacation with me, and there was a cottage there that had the word beach painted along the side of it with an arrow pointing towards the beach, and thought it would be a really cute spot for a photo. It didn't look like anyone was renting that cottage at the time, so I went and took pictures. It wasn't until after I took a few photos that I noticed there was someone sitting on the porch outside behind a bush the entire time, and came up to my mom and I and asked about what we were doing. I told them about my account and they were pretty chill and then let me take more photos, but I still felt so awkward. Yeah, whenever someone goes up to me and like asks what I'm doing, it's always just a little bit awkward. I'm like, please stay away as far as you can. When they like stand there and stare at you too, like that's kind of the worst. Okay, AG of today said, so last year before the panini put everything on lockdown, my mom and I drove about 3 hours to southern Minnesota to meet with a woman who I had brought dolls from a few years prior. She was an older collector who was selling some of her twin daughter's items from the 1990s, who I later befriend. She was very supportive of me being an older teenage boy who had a love for dolls. At this time, in early 2020, I was just regaining my love for AG dolls after packing them away after thinking I was too old for dolls. When we met up with her, I told her about that, and she gave me a big hug and told me that it didn't matter if I was too old or if I was a boy, and I could still enjoy the dolls because they made me happy. I ended up bawling in this poor woman's living room the rest of the time. Oh, that is so sweet, and that lady is also really so sweet for being that caring. And yeah, I think we should normalize everyone loving dolls. I think it's really important, and I really love this story. American Girl Boulevard sent in, my best friend is scared of my dolls, and I mean absolutely terrified. Once a few years ago when she slept over, she had made a passing remark about how weirded out that one of the dolls was pointed remotely in her direction. She fell asleep first, so naturally I snuck up to my dollhouse and turned all of their heads to be dead set on her, then went to sleep. I woke up to find her totally freaked out, and it's safe to say she hasn't slept over for a while since then. Oh my goodness, why would you do that? But also, that's really funny. I totally get where she's coming from, but it's completely normal for a lot of people to just have a ton of dolls just staring at them while they sleep, and you know, it's not as bad as they make it seem. Emerald and Amethyst sent in, oh man, in my AP Lang class last year, once we went full virtual, I decided to tell my teacher about my doll account in a moment of weakness. Whenever I see her in the hallway, I'm scared she'll say something, but I sent in some photos to her for assignments and she was actually very supportive. It still scares me though, and I feel like she knows too much. I have also like shared stuff with teachers. I don't know, it's just awkward. I once shared like my YouTube link with my class and it was embarrassing because it just started playing really loud, my intro, the ding ding ding, because that thing is just kind of too loud sometimes. That was embarrassing, but I totally get that. AG Giggle said, when I was 10, we were filming a stop motion in a state park about an hour or so away from where I live, and two of the really popular boys from my class happened to be on that trail too and had to step around our dolls and phone camera. I almost completely covered my face with my hat so they wouldn't see me. Oh man, it's always just like the random teens or just like classmates from school. Yeah, especially if you drive an hour away, you would think you're not gonna see them. I hope it turned out okay. I can tell how that would be a little bit scary. Alakite Loves AG says, the voodooed guy on the bike when we met, and also those nice girls who wanted to take pics. So that's actually something that happened when I met up with her. This guy walked up to us and asked if we were doing voodoo or something. It was really weird. And then we also ran into some random girls who wanted to take pictures of our dolls. So it was a weird experience, and it would have been worse if I was by myself. So it's always nice to go take photos with a friend. Pretty Little Elizabeth said, security guard thought my doll was a baby in my bag when it went through the metal detector. This This is something that I always wonder about because I take some dolls, or normally just one, when I'm like traveling or if I'm going on a plane. And so when it goes through, what's it called? Like the detector thing? No, the x-ray thing. I'm always like, what do they see? Did they just see like a random doll in a bag? Joy Jitter says, I have my dolls as a screensaver, and when I was sharing my screen, I scared my friends. Where does the fear for dolls even come from? Like, is it from horror movies? Because I don't really get why dolls are so scary sometimes. Bibble Dolly says, my dog peed on my Gwen once. Yikes. American Girl Doll Steam Team says, I was taking video last fall in the mountains when I saw a runner coming by. I figured I'd just knock the dolls down and look like I was sitting there with my dog, just chilling. Well, I knocked all but one doll down, who was wearing bright purple. So I was just there, chilling with my dog, with one doll standing over a bunch of dolls laying on the ground. Nothing to see here, sir. Enjoy your run. Wait, why did you have to knock them down, though? Dolllighted_ says, some random drunk girl on a beach once asked me to take pics of her while I was trying to take doll pics. Well, she probably thought you were a good photographer. I mean, you probably took a good picture of her. Alexandra says, only about a year after I came back to collecting, I took Ani Kanani with me on a vacation. When taking photos, a little girl saw me and turned to her mom and said, how come she got to bring her doll with her when I couldn't? Aww. I love bringing my doll with me on vacation. I think it's so much fun to take photos and just capture the memory, but in a, like a doll scale. I just think it's a lot of fun, and those are some of my favorite photos that I've taken, dolls that I brought on vacation. And yeah, those are all your stories. I'm sorry if I didn't get to some of them. There were kind of a lot, but I thought it was really interesting, and I hope this inspired you to maybe go take more photos out in public if you feel comfortable and you feel safe to do it, because I think it really is some of at least my best photos, and I think it's a lot of fun. And I think these stories inspired me, and I hope they inspired you. And let me know if I should do something like this again. So thanks for watching, guys. Bye.